You're playing a good guy this time.
Surprise, surprise, yeah.
So how was that changing gears from playing Kai?
It was so good.
So you didn't have fun playing the villain?
Of course I did. My favorite thing in the world in getting to sort of play make-believe professionally is getting to try on different hats. And the further they are apart, back-to-back, sort of the more exciting it is. So getting to go from that to someone who's so polarizingly different. It's like... delicious. That's great.
There are these hints in the pilot episode that Jake might have maybe gone through something, or I don't know, there's this mystery about his backstory, especially in relationship or in relation to Lex and Jana, is it?
Yeah, Jana.
Can you talk a little bit about that and whether we'll be learning about his backstory there?
Yeah. I mean, you can see that he's someone who's a little bit hardened and a little kind of closed off and introverted. And you know, we don't get fed everything. We don't know exactly why these characters tick the way that they do. We sort of just are thrown into the situation with them. But we do find more and more information out about these relationships. And for them, Lex and Jake were best buds. And Jake actually dated Jana briefly, casually, very briefly. And then shortly thereafter, Lex and Jana ended up together. They're all okay with it, and Jake is very good friends with Jana. There's a full acceptance there. There's no sort of weirdness. But you can feel that there is a little bit of something behind it. Like in the pilot, when Lex goes to move Jana, and she sort of has a second moment where she steps back and says, I'm going to do this right now. He sort of throws in, you know, I've got Jake of all people, like, here to help. So you feel, in that moment alone, you feel that there's something unsaid that's sort of an awkwardness that no one addresses. And that doesn't really play out in an obvious manner, but that is a situation that informs how these people behave. But they are all very close and very accepting of that reality. That's sort of the backstory there. You find out more and more about each character and sort of how they came to be the way they are, but we also don't dwell on that. Mm-hmm. We don't sort of try to explain why everyone has these emotions, like why Jake has a quick temper or any of that. We just sort of, we see it, and we know it is how that person is because something.
Right. There's no flashbacks to your traumatic childhood.
No, we don't do that. But you get little pieces of people sharing about their lives. Mm-hmm. So you know who they are. Mm-hmm. You just don't get everything explained. Yeah.
Julie was saying that your character was originally older.
Yeah.
So what did you do in that audition to make sure you got this role? Because she said you fell in love with the character.
Yeah, well, I actually saw the Belgian format and was just... I read the pilot first. And I was obsessed with the character and with the story, and the world just seemed like such a great sort of stripped down, pretty raw place to play. And I really connected to Jake, and I'm not sure exactly what it was about him. It was just, I felt like I understood the way that he ticked, and I really wanted to embody that. And then I watched the Belgian format and saw that story fleshed out in their show. And our show is very close to the storyline of theirs, but it changes. You know, the setup is very similar, but then the stories evolve in different ways. And the manner of storytelling is very different. But seeing that, knowing who that guy was in their show, just got me so excited, because it's just such an incredible story. It's such a phenomenal character. He's truly a good person, but he's got all this crap that he's dealing with. And complicated people are so much more interesting than buying someone who's just nice.
Sure.
Cost associated with it. You know, but having something that you show that's different than who you are, that sort of juxtaposition is so electric to play. So I think that was what drew me into it. But it's sort of, I sort of call my people and say, this is what I want to do, I don't know how to make it happen. Let's like go after it. And obviously I knew Julie, and so that was a relationship that I didn't have to sort of develop. I went through the whole process. It wasn't like phone calls or like they pitched me for it. I actually went and read for it for her and David. And then I went and read for Warner Brothers and for the CW, and sort of had to show them my take on the character.